In This Week in Military History, we explore the American surrender of Fort Detroit to the British during the War of 1812. The War of 1812 began on June 18, 1812, and stemmed from economic and trade issues between America and Great Britain, Canada, and France. American troops manned forts amongst the Great Lakes in defense of the Canadian border. Brigadier General William Hull, the American governor of the Michigan Territory, commanded operations in the region and led the Army of the Northwest. The message from President James Madison, which included notice of the declaration of war, reached Hull on July 1st as his forces were moving northward to defend the border. At 60 years of age, Hull was more cautious than he had been during his service in the American Revolution and recommended caution to his subordinates. On July 9, Hull received a letter from William Eustis, the American Secretary of War, which instructed him to begin offensive operations, including the capture of Fort Malden. Hull was convinced that he did not have enough men to accomplish this directive, as Native American tribes had begun to gather in support of the British soldiers. Hull and his forces crossed the Detroit River on July 12, whereupon the British forces withdrew. Hull dispatched his units to gather supplies from the countryside to deny them to the British. American reinforcements were ordered to Detroit, but supply and communication lines had already been cut. With not enough men to take Fort Malden, American units were dispatched south to reinforce the supply and communication lines to Fort Detroit. British Major General Brock and his soldiers arrived in the vicinity of Fort Malden. Brock held a council with the Shawnee Chief Tecumseh on August 13th, in which Tecumseh expressed the support of his warriors. Outnumbered and with unsteady supply and communication lines, Hull surrendered Fort Detroit to the British on August 15, 1812. Paroled by the British in 1813, Hull was arrested by the Americans and court-martialed. Hull was charged with treason for not attacking Fort Malden and surrendering Fort Detroit, cowardice for not attacking Fort Malden, and neglect of duty. The court found Hull guilty on the cowardice and dereliction of duty charges and sentenced him to be shot. President Madison commuted the execution portion of his sentencing and dismissed Hull from the Army. Join us next time for another segment of This Week in Military History with the Pritzker Military Museum and Library.